in the opening, and Ms. Persso will go second in the closing. Ms. Persso will go first, and Ms. Murphy will go second. So, further ado, I'd like to, and we'll have 4 minutes, as I said before, 4 minutes for the opening, 2 minutes to answer questions, 2 minutes for the closing.
Okay, well, thank you, everybody, for being here. One of the things that I love the best about this community is all the people here in this audience, because all of you make this community what it is. We're here not because we agree, but because we care. And we care about the issues that are so important to all of us, the schools for our children, keeping them safe from gun violence, transportation, being able to get to and from work, making sure the subway works because you've got a 5 o'clock deadline for your child care. We care, and that is why we are a good, solid community. And we're what this whole area is all about. It is that we are involved and committed to this community. I ran for the House of Delegates because I am committed to this community. I care about all of the issues that you care about. Transportation, education, and certainly economic development, because of course our quality of life depends on how good our schools are, how easily we can move around, and that's what attracts business to this area. So as your delegate, I've been very proud to be your voice in Richmond, to stand up for the issues that are so important, to speak out, to be heard. Otherwise, those words are just words, unless we translate them into a way that we can be impactful. And that's what I have been for this district. And I'm very proud, and I'm very honored. And I can tell you, when I stood up and I took the oath of office on the House of Delegates floor, it was overwhelming. It was overwhelming to stand there and realize that I was now serving in the House where Thomas Jefferson once served, where Patrick Henry and James Madison and James Monroe and so many others had walked before me. And I take this very seriously, and I'm honored, and I value it, and I look at this job not as a step up to someplace else, but as a commitment to this community to represent you in the strongest way that I can, and to be there to listen to you and to help make this a better place for us to live and raise our children. And that is what I've done this year, and that is what I hope I will continue to do when you vote for me November 3rd and reelect me.